Is Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon going to be exclusive to Xbox? Let's talk about it.
Whoa!
What's up, guys? Canadian Guy here, and back with another video talking about this mind-blowing news that we heard just the other day. The short and sweet is Xbox bought out Activision Blizzard. All of it. I mean all of it, which now means that the previous pseudo PlayStation mascots, Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon, are now owned by Xbox. What timeline are we living in? So, I went through the comments of my previous video and on Twitter, and there is one resounding question and comment that's been coming forward. One that has been head and shoulders above the rest. Will Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon be exclusive to Xbox? Will I have to buy an Xbox to play those games? If this were to happen, that would mean that the once pseudo PlayStation mascots would no longer be available on PlayStation consoles. Thus, if you wanted to play these titles, you would either have to get an Xbox or have a PC and hope that it comes to PC Game Pass as soon as possible. So, will Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon be Xbox exclusive now? Well, there is evidence to suggest that this is not going to happen. Let's dive in. First and foremost, before we even get to what Phil Spencer has said on the matter, let's get to the general market view. Crash and Spyro have been known as PlayStation stars since the late 90s. And that marketing of being a pseudo first party game has carried over to even today. People still think that at one point Sony owned Crash and Spyro. They have not. But the majority of sales on Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon are on the PlayStation family of consoles. Xbox should be able to see that and recognize that console sales aren't what makes a majority of the money, but game sales. Because Crash and Spyro sell way better on PlayStation, Xbox would just be shooting themselves in the foot if they didn't give access to those games to Sony as well. Now, will there be some strings attached? Probably. This could come with an exclusive release window, like releasing 2 weeks early on one console family and then being released elsewhere. This also could be exclusive skins, DLC, etc. That is a definite possibility in terms of exclusivity, but not going to Sony at all? I believe that's a big mistake. But Xbox has actually been the company that has started to branch out to other platforms. For example, Ori and the Blind Forest is also on Nintendo Switch. Now, the development company, Moon Studios, is not a studio that's owned by Xbox, but the Ori IP is. That means Xbox can hand the IP to whomever they wish to develop a new game if they so wished. They also still released Deathloop, a Bethesda title, to PlayStation and PC, not even Xbox yet. Now, some of you might say, yeah, but Deathloop was announced for PlayStation before they were acquired by Microsoft. They are just honoring the previous agreement. That is true, but they also have owned Minecraft since 2014. Do you see any exclusivity? No, you can still play it on PlayStation consoles. In fact, in 2020, they released Minecraft Dungeons, which was released on Xbox, PlayStation, PC, and Nintendo Switch. Minecraft is a giant billion-dollar IP, and Xbox not only released it to PlayStation, but all available consoles at the time. That is a huge thing to consider when we move to the next subject. Bloomberg had an interview with Phil Spencer asking many questions about the acquisition and how it's going to affect the industry as a whole. Phil had said the following quote, quote, "I'll just say to players out there who are playing Activision Blizzard games on Sony's platform, it's not our intent to pull communities away from that platform, and we remain committed to that." To add on to this, Phil also tweeted the following, quote, "Had good calls this week with the leaders at Sony. I confirmed our intent to honor all existing agreements upon acquisition of Activision Blizzard and our desire to keep Call of Duty on PlayStation. Sony is an important part of our industry, and we value our relationship. Now, these quotes should overall satisfy you. Even though he didn't specify Crash and Spyro on the second tweet, he is making broad statements about Activision as a whole still being present on Sony consoles. As long as Phil holds to his word, he has no intention of ripping communities apart, which means that we will more than likely still see our two favorite lads on PlayStation consoles. To gain an additional reassurance, Sony actually commented on the matter to the Washington State Journal, saying that, quote, "We expect that Microsoft will abide by contractual agreements and continue to ensure Activision games are multi-platform. There is currently agreements between Sony and Activision that will likely have to be worked out, but even Sony expects Microsoft to keep Activision games as multi-platform. But remember, there will likely be some form of exclusivity for Xbox." So that should be it, right? No more issues or questions? Actually, there is one more that I am actually shocked that I have to answer. It's a massive stretch, but people are taking it and running with it, so I am going to answer this burning question. Actually, it's more like an accusation, but let's get to answering it. Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon being bought by Xbox is bad because we haven't had a new Banjo-Kazooie or Conker's Bad Fur Day. Because of that, it's obvious that Microsoft hates platformers and they want to bury the Crash and Spyro IPs. Okay, so there is two answers to this. Let's do the first and most obvious one, Psychonauts 2. Literally, that's it. Psychonauts 2. Literally, it's a brand new platformer in the vein of the 3D classics and released not only on Xbox, but PlayStation as well. It was nominated for so many awards and did very, very, very well critically. We can't measure sales because of, well, Game Pass, but overall, the game did great. So, even if Microsoft hated platformers, this would have proved them wrong. But I don't think it's Xbox that's stopping people from getting Banjo-Kazooie or Conker's Bad Fur Day. Xbox said in a statement to Video Games Chronicle that a brand new Banjo-Kazooie or Conker is up to Rare, following up with the statement from Phil Spencer himself, quote, "I leave it up to the studios in terms of things that they want to go work on," Spencer said. "I have a lot of respect for Rare and the work that they do. They do like building new things, and they've seen success with Sea of Thieves. I think they're really excited about Everwild." This lines up with previous statements of previous workers who have worked at Xbox Game Studios, saying that Phil Spencer essentially lets the studios figure out and decide what they want to work on. Rare at the moment doesn't want to work on older IPs, period, but wants to work on brand new games. Phil is letting them handle when Banjo comes back. Who knows, maybe a new developer will approach Rare and allow them to handle Banjo-Kazooie. But that's not the point. The point I'm trying to make is that Xbox aren't the ones holding Banjo back in terms of a new game. Therefore, it's not Xbox that hates platformers. Xbox is leaving it up to Rare to figure out when Banjo comes back. In fact, to tie it to the beginning of this video, a few days ago, Xbox helped and released Banjo-Kazooie on Nintendo Switch through Nintendo Switch Online, further showing that Xbox understands where the core audience is for franchises and allowing Banjo-Kazooie back to his home, meaning that they would also understand where Crash and Spyro's homes are. That is on the PlayStation console. At the moment, if you are a PlayStation-only person, I would not worry about future installments of Crash and Spyro not being on PlayStation. There probably will be some Xbox exclusivity, but probably not platform exclusivity. Do you have any other questions about this acquisition? Let me know in the comment section below, and if enough people ask a question or like a comment, I'll try to turn it into a video.